with wonderfulwoodworking.com, and today what we'd like to do is do video number two on building a glider rocker love seat. And as you can see here off to the my left here, we have up to date where we're at, and we've built in video one, we built the base to the glider, and now we have built the two end frames for the actual bench that will glide back and forth. And what I'd like to do is just go through that a little bit with you as to how that came about. Just to save a little time, I went ahead and did this here because as far as the joinery and that on it was done with the lamella tool or the biscuits, as you may be familiar with, so I didn't see much point in going through that part again with it. But at any rate, this is what the ends end up being here for the actual seat itself to sit on. The seat will sit on here, there'll be armrest on here, and then of course the back goes up the back somewhat. So this is actually quite simple to make too. We have a blueprint or diagrams here to go by, and I will be posting them on my website when I get this all together and post the videos on there too. So that's what we're at right now. So once again, I can't enforce long enough to go ahead and make yourself some templates here for future use. Say in the event that maybe 6 months down the road or whatever, you may want to build a second or a third one, you will have the template which will take all the guesswork out of it, because you do that type of thing one time. You shouldn't have to do it every time you want to build another one. I built another template here for this top part here, is for the seat itself. As you can see, there's a little bit of a curve in it, so that the seat does dish out, and this here will come handy down the way for that. Now once again, the base is made. We took and rounded off the corners here. This is just, everything is a 2x4 spruce in this particular case, but it can be cedar, or if you wanted to even go ahead and do it up in oak or even in maple, the choice is yours. It'll work in any case of any species of wood that you want to do it in. It's just nothing changes. The plan is the same thing, the cuts are the same. It's just that you don't want to screw up too much if you're into, say, oak or maple, this type of thing. You want to check your cuts twice before you go and cut them. It's all that simple. But here what we did, we just made the base according to the diagram here. And the length is 22 inches. And what we did here was just rounded off the corners. I just took a plain old tin can with the circumference about that size and just drew an arc on there and took and cut that out on my bandsaw. Now, if you don't have a bandsaw, the jigsaw will do the job just as well for you too. There's nothing wrong with that part, because you end up sanding it and cleaning everything up real nice with that. What I like to do here on all the edges of my work in that is I like to run it over the router and just round off the corners a little bit. So you've got a quarter inch round edge on there, so it's not a sharp edge that, you know, it just looks better and it feels better as you use it. Now, on these legs here, for instance, you'll see that one is on an angle, the other one is straight up and down. Now, the measurement on the straight leg is 28 inches from the top to the very bottom of the base. This one here ends up being 29 inches from the long corner down to here, with a 15 degree angle down in this area here. Very critical that you get that angle right and get these in the same, in the right position here on the base. Now in this particular base, what you want to do is find dead center, which is 22 inches, so dead center would be at 11. Now, your distance between the two legs here is 7 inches, so you'd go 3.5 inches on each side of the center mark, and that's where the inside of these legs would be positioned. very critical that you do get that in the right location. The same thing as on the base when that was made too. It's very critical to find center point and work from center out on there. Now, as far as the glue-ups and that, like I said, we use biscuits in here. There's two biscuits in each upright, and the grooves are cut with the machine here, and then the little biscuits are glued and squeezed into place with a put a clamp on there and squeeze them down nice and tight and just let them sit for 3-4 hours at least. In this case here, they sat overnight, so they're well done. Then after that, I just went ahead and I ran everything over the router, cleaned that up, sanded it all, and there we are at present. Now this here is the base here that your seat itself will sit on. Now the dimensions that they give you for that is 14.5 inches from the bottom of this here 2x4 to the very base of the framing here. And as you can see, this here will be the back part with the angle and your front part here. So if you go by your instructions and that, does a pretty good job of explaining how this all works, and just be a little bit accurate while you're doing it, because I'm assuming now when we go to put our straps on here to make this thing glide back and forth, we're going to have to be pretty accurate with all this, so both sides synchronize at the same time while we're gliding on it. So, yeah. Now you'll notice there is a right and a left side for this system here too, but common sense will tell you that as you're building it, and we'll go from there. Now the overall width of this thing when it's completed, they say it should end up at 58.5 inches from the very outside of the armrests, which would be sticking out there about another 4 inches on each side. So, you know, if you choose that you want something a little wider or a little narrower, you can adjust that here with these 2x4s here that hold the base together, and then as a result, you would either lengthen or shorten your 1x4s that make up the seat in this here. So, whatever you do to one, you'll have to do to the other, so they both match up in the end. So, okay, I think we've covered everything I want to cover here in video 2. And our next get-together will be video 3, and what we'll be doing is actually building the bench itself. Thank you.